During the 9th Forum on China-Africa Cooperation held in Beijing in September, Uganda signed two critical export protocols with China, marking a new chapter in the country's agricultural trade. While making this revelation at the media center today, Frank Tumwebaze, the Minister of Agriculture, Animal Industry and Fisheries, described the protocols as a significant leap forward for Uganda's agricultural export development and a key step toward balancing trade relations with China. The first protocol concerns the export of wild aquatic products such as Nile perch fillets, fish maw, and silverfish, while the second addresses the export of dried chilies.
Protocol number one is on inspection, quarantine, and sanitary requirements of wild aquatic products. We were not being able to sell these products to China until this protocol has been signed. So the products under this protocol include Nile perch fillets, headless and gutted Nile perch, fish maw, fish skins, fish scales, silver fish, or what you call mukene, products to be exported from Uganda to China.
The signing of the protocols is expected to have a transformative impact on Uganda's agricultural sector by providing direct access to the Chinese market, which has a population of 1.4 billion people. Tumwebaze emphasized that this development will streamline the export process for Uganda's traders and boost their earnings.
For Uganda's agricultural export development, and will contribute to creating a balance of trade with China. With the combined efforts of MAIF is Ministry of Agriculture, Animal Industry and Fisheries, and the private sector, producers, processors, exporters, among others, Uganda is well positioned to meet the demands of the Chinese market while ensuring the high standards of food safety and quality in its exports.
The protocols were signed by the Ministry of Agriculture and the General Administration of the Customs of the People's Republic of China, GACC. The murder trial of Henry Katanga resumed with the cross-examination of prosecution witness number 8, Andrew Kizimula Mubiru, the Director of Forensics at the Uganda Police Force. Today, the case was presided over by Justice Isaac Muwata, with the accused Molly participating in the proceedings via an audio-video link, while her co-accused were physically present in court. Defense lawyers led by Mark Dosman Kabega quizzed Mubiru on the deoxyribonucleic acid DNA analysis, which he carried out on exhibits that he was not availed by the police.
Find out the comparison. The swab, which they did not have. And the request I have is as per PIDE 1B.
It was revealed that Mubiru examined DNA sample exhibits from the alleged killer's gun, which was not part of the request placed by the police. The prosecution suggested that Mubiru overstepped his mandate. The defense lawyer informed the court that Mubiru would be required for further questioning during the visit to the crime scene, a prayer the judge granted.
The police do not have swab from Naira. And it was actually you who asked them to do it. So you are the one who asked the police to provide you with Naira's swab. I know that's not true.
The court proceeding was followed by the prosecution led by Samali Waholi, cross-examined the 8th witness. The case hearing was adjourned to tomorrow when the same witness shall be examined further.
I would want Samali back on the stand when at the appropriate time I wrote an application to visit the scene.
You see from that illustration the trigger in contact with that service.
I know my road. My road. the trigger house is not in contact with the surface for growth.
The late Katanga's wife, Molly Katanga, is facing trial together with her daughters, Patricia Kakwanza and Martha Nkwanzi, as well as George Amanire, a domestic worker, and Charles Otai, a nursing officer, who are accused of destroying evidence and being accessories to the mother. The Kenyan capital, Nairobi, is experiencing heightened security measures as Parliament Road remains closed and police maintain a strong presence around Parliament buildings. This increased vigilance comes in anticipation of a contentious impeachment motion against Deputy President Rigathi Gachagua. Deputy President Rigathi Gachagua is facing 10 allegations outlined in an impeachment motion drafted by Kibwezi West Member of Parliament Mutuse Mwengi, calling for his removal from office. Mwengi accuses Gachagua of cross violations of the constitution, including promoting ethnic discrimination and undermining national unity through divisive public statements. Gachagua is accused of contradicting government policies and failing to uphold his duties as deputy president, thus violating the principle of collective cabinet responsibility. The motion further alleges that Gachagua interfered with devolved county functions, undermining devolution and threatening the judiciary, violating the principle of judicial independence. National Assembly Speaker Moses Wetangula is expected to formally notify Parliament of the impeachment motion today, although debate will not commence immediately.